As I told you earlier, X-ray and gamma ray observations can be made only from space-based probes and satellites, and therefore one may ask the question, and the space missions are very complex, expensive, cost a lot of resources and take a lot of time to develop. So one may ask, what is it that we learn new by observations in X-rays and gamma rays which you cannot observe, cannot study from ground-based studies in visible radio band? The reason is that the high energy universe, okay, matter at very high density, typically 10 to 6, 10 to 14 gram per cc, which you find in white dwarf, neutron stars, bright black hole, is best studied in X-ray region and gamma ray region. The reason being that X-rays and gamma rays require high temperature gas to produce, and such gas can be produced when matter from a companion star accretes or falls into the gravitational potential of this object, neutron star and black hole, and it attains very high temperature and radiates. And therefore, the such objects are the brightest X-ray sources, as I told you, the binary stars in which they are found. Now, high temperature gas are radiates in X-rays. I give you example of sun. Sun is a corona, 2 million degree. Similarly, thermal X-rays are produced in supernova remnants. Supernova remnants at temperatures ranges from million degrees to tens of million degrees. Then your hot interstellar medium, where also the gas radiates in form of low energy X-rays. Your clusters of galaxies, where intracluster gas gets heated up due to the movement of the most of the galaxies and radiates in X-rays. Then your hot stars, stars which are known as what you call astronomical languages, O stars and B stars, which have high temperature, they also radiate in X-rays, and they have corona, very high temperature corona, and so on. Okay. Similarly, when there are high energy particles you want to study, because if you want to produce X-rays by a process known as a synchrotron emission and inverse Compton process, I will not go into details of that, but these are known as non-thermal processes or non-thermal emission. So you will require electron for synchrotron process, which are energy in the range of 10 to 14 to 10 to 11, 18 electron volt. So if you want to observe high energy universe, that is you make matter at very high density, at very high temperature, photons, electrons are matter at very high energy and very high magnetic field which is found in neutron star, then X-ray provides the best medium to probe the universe. Next slide, please. So what are the, now let's briefly look at what are the important sources of X-rays. In galaxy, they are X-ray binaries, they are the brightest sources, I told you, in the case of Scorpius X1, and neutron star black hole in this binary are powerful X-ray emitters. I think this is a simple equation just to tell you that luminosity of an X-ray source depends on gravitational constant, which is then mass of the X-ray emitting star, that is neutron star, black hole in this case, in its radius, and the mass accretion rate m dot, dot is not here, okay? And because the mass of the neutron star is about mass of the sun, while the radius is only 10 to 15 kilometer, therefore you can see gm over r, or the gravitational potential, is extremely high. As a result, the matter from the companion star, which falls into the gravitational potential of a neutron star black hole, can attain very high temperature, very high energy, and that is why you see generation of X-rays. So now we have discovered several hundred neutron star sources in our galaxy, about 400 of them, black hole sources. White dwarf sources are a little fainter, because a typical white dwarf has a diameter of the size of the Earth, about 5,000, 6,000 kilometers, and that is why their gravitational potential is less, therefore X-ray luminosity is lower. Next slide, please.